Now, after we have discussed what the a map is, what is the definition of a map, we have discussed its merits and demerits. One thing I would like to point out is what you already know, that a collection of maps is called an atlas. Like, you already have an atlas in, prescribed in your school syllabus, and if you open an atlas, you will see various type of maps that are enlisted there. So a collection of different type of maps, political, physical, agricultural, all these maps together in a book is called an atlas. Now we are discussing the two types of maps. So maps can either be small scale maps or they can be a large scale map. Now when we are discussing a small scale map, as you can see, these maps show a large area of land on a small space. For example, a map showing continents and countries. Whereas a large scale map, these maps show a small area of land on a large space. For example, towns or cities. So if I'm trying to show a world map or I'm trying to show a map of India, I will be using a small scale map because I have to show a very big area on a small piece of paper. Naturally, in that case, the distance which I will be assuming will be very big. So I may be taking 1 centimeter as 1,000 kilometers or 1 centimeter as 500 kilometer, because we cannot show much of details and because we are covering a very large stretch of land. So these are the three features of small scale maps. That these maps show a large area of land on a small piece of paper, like a map showing continents or countries. They cannot show much details because they are showing a very large area, and the scale that we assume, it may be either 1 centimeter equals to 1,000 kilometer or 1 centimeter equals to 500 kilometer. Just the opposite will be a large scale map. Small scale map is showing a large area, but a large scale map always focuses on a small area. So it may be showing a town or a city or a colony, a smaller area it will focus on. Naturally, if it is focusing on a smaller area, it will be giving us a lot of details of that area. And naturally, if I am showing a small area on a map, I can assume smaller distances, like 1 centimeter equals to 1 kilometer or 1 centimeter equals to 10 kilometers. Smaller distances I can show because it's a small piece of land. So this is the difference, and it's a very important difference that can come as a 2-mark question in your exam. Differentiate between small scale map and large scale map. I will be sending this picture. Please note it down in your geography copies. So when we are discussing the features of a large scale map, first definition will be: a large scale map is a map that shows a small area of land on a large space. The features of a large scale map, naturally they are showing a small area in details. In your book it mentions, for example, a topographical map. A topographical map is basically a map that shows the natural and man-made features of a small area. Suppose if I am taking an area, say Raza Bazaar, so all the natural things which are there, all the man-made things, the shops and the clinics, hospitals that are there, all those features that will be shown on that particular topographical map. And for such a kind of map, we can use a small scale because we are focusing on a very small area. Secondly, both natural and man-made features are shown with suitable colors or signs or symbols. Suppose if I am trying to represent a mountain in that area, I can use a dark brown triangle facing upward to show that I am showing a mountain. If I want to show some man-made feature like police station, I will use a conventional sign PS as police station. If I want to show a post office, I will use the conventional sign PO. These conventional signs are basically accepted internationally and we can only use them to show on a map. So these kind of signs and symbols can be used on a large scale map. And lastly, since we said that we are discussing a small area, we can take smaller distances. So a scale may be selected as 1 centimeter equals to 1 kilometer, which clearly shows the details of that particular small area. So please remember, the difference is a very important question. What are the differences between small scale map and large scale maps? So small scale map, they show a large area of land on a smaller space, for example, continents or countries. Large scale map, they show a small area on a larger space, like towns or cities. Small scale map naturally showing a large area, they cannot show much details. Large scale map showing a small area can naturally show a lot of details. Small scale map, since it's covering a very large distance, the scale may be 1 centimeter is equals to 1000 kilometer or 1 centimeter is equal to 500 kilometers. Whereas on a large scale, we are representing a very small area. So 1 centimeter scale is equals to 1 kilometer or 10 kilometers. I hope it's clear to all of you.